Hey everyone, Joe here. Welcome to part 10 of the Pro Tools First Pro course. In this part, we're going to be talking about MIDI. I'm going to be showing you how to set up a MIDI instrument and record and edit MIDI with Pro Tools First. So before you set up your MIDI device in Pro Tools First, you're going to need to install the driver, and the process to that is going to be largely the same depending on which device you have, but it's going to differ slightly. So for me, I've got a Novation Launch Key 25. So it's just a case of me going to the Novation website, downloading the correct driver and installing it on my PC. So you'll need to do that first, whether that's a disc that comes with your controller or it will just give you a link or something like that. But once that's all installed and you rebooted your system, then you want to open up Pro Tools First again. And then the first thing you want to do is you want to go into Setup, and then this is where you'll find your MIDI settings. So if we go to MIDI input devices, if you've installed it all correctly, you should have some options here. You just want to check the one for your device. So there are a few different ones for mine. We've got the MIDI in, the launch key, and just the Focusrite USB driver. So I've got those all checked. Click OK to set that up. And then next, once you've linked your device, you want to go to MIDI input filter. This allows you to turn on and off certain controls on your MIDI controller. So it's up to you if you don't want certain things to be picked up, like modulation or something. You can check that because we're on all except. So it's going to be picking up everything except the ones you've checked. But this is fine how we have it. You could just set it to all so that anything from your controller will be picked up by the software. Now we want to test the device and record something with it. So create a new track, go to track and press new, and then let's create a stereo instrument track. You might see this MIDI track here, it might catch your eye. We'll go over that in a minute, but for now we'd want an instrument track, and then just click create. Let's just double click on the name and call it piano for now. Open that out a bit. So this track will let you record MIDI data using a virtual instrument. So it works in a very similar way to the audio tracks if you've used those before, but it's only going to work if we have a virtual instrument as an insert. So click on the first insert and go to multi-channel plugin and have a look at what instruments you've got. So we've got a few different ones here. UVI workstation is a sampler. Expand, we're going to go for that for now. Expand 2. It's just got loads and loads of different virtual instruments. This is your first instrument here, and if you click on the drop down there, you can see all these pads, pianos, percussions, all sorts. Let's just click on acoustic piano and go for a natural grand piano. Now, if you press a key, click record first to arm the track, and then press a key on your controller, and you'll see some signal coming through. There are all sorts of adjustments we can make on this, but for now we're just going to leave it as the piano. Also going to create a click track, just so we can play to the click, and we're on 120 beats per minute. So if we bring it back to the beginning, hit record, or you can press F12, classic four chords. So yeah, that's recorded absolutely fine. We know that's all set up and working, and you'll see you've got your MIDI data recorded here. If you wanted to, you could record some more. You could create a new track and record a different instrument. You can, we'll go over how to edit it, but you can even change the sound after, because it's a virtual instrument, so we could change that from the piano without having to re-record. There's just one thing to point out that's really important. If you record over this now, I'm going to show you, I'm going to hit record and then put some bass notes in. You'll see that it's actually overwriting all your data, which is probably not what you want, unless you do want to genuinely replace it. But if you want to add something, we call it MIDI merge. So have a look for this icon up here. Highlight it, click it, and then try again. And there we go. So that merges it instead of overwrites it. It's non-destructive. Now let's talk about editing your MIDI that you've recorded. So if you find any of these clips of MIDI and double click on one, if you're using the smart tool or the hand, you can just click on the bottom here where the hand comes up and it opens up the MIDI editor down here. Let's bring this up and you can see the individual notes and make changes to any of them. So we can move it around. You can see that it's on a grid with beats and bars. If you have your editing set on slip, you're going to be able to move the notes smoothly. If it's on grid, then you'll be able to snap them to the grid. So if you want it super tight and in time, you can snap them all to the grid if that's what you want. But this is piano. Let's keep it a little bit natural. We're not going to get everything bang on. And then at the bottom here, you've got your other parameters. So it's set on velocity, which is how hard the note's been hit, and you can edit these as well. So if I highlight a note, you'll see the note that it is, and you can change the velocity setting. So if we highlighted everything with Control A or Command A and brought the velocity right up, then it would sound like we're really smashing on that piano. So you can very easily make changes to individual notes. If you click on the drop down here, you'll find the other options to change parameters as well. So things like volume, pan, pitch bend. So if you click on one of them, I wouldn't really pitch bend a piano in most situations, I don't think, but I'm going to click on it and just show you just as an example. So if you've, because we weren't using the pitch bend wheel on the MIDI controller, it's at zero, but you could change that afterwards. So if I recorded using the pitch bend, then you'd see this is somewhere else other than zero. But I can change it. You can change everything. That's the beauty of MIDI. So if I, for example, clicked on the pencil tool to draw in some automation changes, just did a little wiggly line there, you'll hear the pitch bend. There you go. And while we're on the pencil tool, you can also use it to draw in MIDI. So even if you don't have a MIDI controller, you could just draw it in with the pencil tool. Now let's have a quick look at these other instruments that I've recorded. So let's have a look at this kick. Got another instance of expand on this track as well. Let's just have a quick listen. I used the pads on this, the drum pad, so it's super loud. Let's bring that velocity down across the board. It's not quite so slamming in our eardrums. A little bit more than that. Okay. Now you can see this is super out of time. That's thanks to my playing and also the delay on the keyboard. So we could bring all these back in time by moving them around with the hand, but that's going to take a little while, especially if we had a much longer song. So what we're going to do instead is quantize, which is going to automatically snap it to the nearest grid line. Now some of these are in the middle, they're on the sort of eighth note, and it wouldn't be able to snap them. So I'm going to increase the amount of lines, increase the resolution of the grid by clicking on this drop down here. You see grid up there, going to eighth note. So now we'll be able to snap to the grid where we want it. But if we highlight this, just drag over it or press Control or Command A and go to Event Operations, Quantize, we're going to be able to snap all of these notes to the grid. So let's click Apply and it's moved it all for us. Now I'm not sure if that's going to be completely in time because I might have not played near the correct grid line, but yeah, that one hasn't. Pretty much though, I mean that saved us an awful lot of time, and if it had been played a little bit better, it might have done it without having to do any manual editing. And let's have a look at the snare as well. It's almost in time, so I think if we quantize that, it will just snap it all in the right place. So again, edit, event operations quantize, or you can press Alt 0. I'm just going to click OK. Oh, that one's a bit off. There we go. And then I'll quickly do the same with the hi-hat too. And I don't want that one in there. I didn't like that. So I can highlight that, I'll click on it and just press the delete key to get rid of it. Now let's have a listen to the whole thing. Okay, and that's basic MIDI editing. Obviously it's a super simple song, but just to demonstrate the editing you have available to you. I'm gonna shorten that one as well. Let's open that. That's another way. You can double click it, or you can right click and click in open in MIDI editor. Then we're gonna highlight those, and you can drag the length of those notes back. And then if we also bring those right to the front there, I'm going to show you how to duplicate so we can do a loop of the whole piece. Chop that off, so we've just got those four bars. Highlight everything, and you can do one of two things. You can either hold Control C to copy and then Control V to paste, or Command on a Mac. Just highlight all the track, just select all the tracks that you're copying to. Or more simple way, if you select everything, might as well do it with two now, and hold Control or Command and press D for duplicate. We can just copy as many as we want, and then that'll give us a nice loop. I also mentioned that I was going to talk about that other track type, the MIDI track. So if you open up a MIDI track, it's just gonna hold MIDI data on it. So it's not, you're not gonna be able to hear it because you can't put any insert, but it will hold MIDI data. So you could still record to this. If we hit record, but you won't be able to hear it. If you drag that on to an instrument track, you would be able to. Now, another thing you can do is import. Now, if you imported a MIDI track that's already been created into Pro Tools first, it would come up as MIDI data. It wouldn't automatically give you instruments. I'm just gonna demonstrate that now. If drag in a MIDI file, and then it's gonna give us some import options. So it's gonna ask you if you wanna do put it on instrument tracks or MIDI tracks, which if you know you wanna assign some virtual instruments, it's easier to just do instrument tracks straight away. But for a demonstration, I'm gonna go MIDI track. You can also choose where you want it to start in the session. So it's going to come right at the beginning, import all the information, the tempo, if your MIDI file has that in. But just so we don't mess up the song we've already got, we'll leave that off for now. So let's just click OK. And there you see, it'll bring everything in on MIDI tracks. And then you could move that over to instrument tracks if you needed to. But you could also use it if you just wanted to import the tempo data and everything. You could have it so it just comes in on MIDI tracks, imports the tempo data, and then you can just go ahead and delete these after. And one other quick thing that can be helpful is if you don't want to view these as clips and have to open up the MIDI editor every time, you can use this drop down and view it as notes instead, which means you've got the MIDI editor right there basically. If we drop this down, we'll be able to see the automation, the parameters and everything right there. And yeah, you can draw it in with the pencil, and you can always swap that back to clips after. But you can see that you can even choose velocity, and you're able to see the velocity as well as the notes. It just depends on your workflow really. So now you've got your MIDI tracks set up, and you'll have recorded some MIDI using your MIDI controller. Let me know in the comments section below what you've been recording. It'd be great to know, and even hear some if you want to post some links once you're finished. The next part, part 11, we're moving on to the mixing stage. So I'm going to be showing you how to use plugins, assign plugins to your tracks to change the sound and make things sound exactly the way you want them to. So hit that subscribe button so you don't miss that part. And as always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in part 11.